All right, guys, we're going to take a tour of the final result. We're moving in the next 3-4 days for good. So we're going to start with the garage. It isn't done, but it's getting pretty close. Even still, with all this shelving, we still feel like we're short on storage, but we're still organizing stuff. Main toolbox, of course, goes there. Mini toolbox may be under the window. I'm not sure. I don't know if it'll fit. The damn sprinkler pump, a few of my tools, radios, cords, bottles up, things like that. My wall of beauty, my wall of hardware, my Subaru wall, some tools, garden tools. That's the garage. I painted from that top ceiling line down and over, painted everything forward because of a little water leak accident we had upstairs, which was a dumb mistake. So I just sealed it with some Kills paint and took care of it a little bit. So that's the only reason I painted the garage, just from like here forward. So it was all stained and black, so it actually was worth it in the end. I taped off the little control area here so it'd stay white, just for, I don't know, effect or something, whatever. Okay, let's go to the next room. The laundry room, right from the garage. Painted this also, everything, including roof, including shelves. There are all new outlets and switches in the entire house, period. I didn't miss one. So I'm not gonna say that in every room, but I'll show you some specialty stuff later. But every single switch has a nice solid feel, really solid clunk, not just loose and iffy like all your old switches and plugs all over the house. The plugs are hard to even push in, they're so tight and snug. Anyway, what else, would I do anything here? No, I didn't replace that yet. I'm about to. I did install this nice little broom rack type of thing, and it does not interfere with the door, which is really sweet. Just barely, you can still open the door just right. All right, let's check out the TV/family room next. Now, I don't have any lights in here yet, so you'll have to deal with that. No lights in here. I did take off the AC vent and put 3 coats of white paint on it, clean it up. It was all rusty, you know, whatever. Fixing everything up. The whole fireplace was black. If you look at the first video I made a long time ago, now it's natural gray matching the upstairs paint. Also did a quick spray of some black high temp in here to clean up some of the stains. And of course, Gerald, my neighbor across the street with a 2007 Jeep Unlimited playlist, did all 3 of my floors. We did them, but he was the expert and I was doing his cuts and learning about floors and how to do them. So this floor is completely done. A couple of the other ones aren't quite done, but we have nice quarter round molding everywhere, nice transitions. Beautiful floor. I mean, this was like black dirty carpet when we first got this place. You might be able to see that in the first video. Let's just transition without a cut into the kitchen. The kitchen was one of the places that was redone before we moved in. I like the greenish paint, whatever. It's just a nice tropical kind of feel. Small-ish kitchen, you know. It might be a tiny bit smaller than our other kitchen, but maybe not. Kitchen table will go here, a little breakfast table, a cereal table, whatever. All new switches again, nice dimmer. Nice. I have a USB plug in almost every room, just somewhere randomly. So you always have somewhere to pop in your USBs, charge your phones and things like that. Kind of cool. I put 1 GFI socket in every place that had water, a bathrooms, kitchen. 1 GFI socket, wired it correctly through the load of the breaker inside that socket. We didn't do really much of anything in here. I love these cabinets. They're beautiful. I mean, compared to what we came from, are you kidding? These are even straight. We just had junky, rusty, chipped everything back there. These are beautiful, beautiful cabinets. I really like them. And, oh, actually, we don't have a dimmer. We have the kitchen lights. We have probably the garbage disposal. Okay. And we have the under cabinet lights across the whole board. Pretty dang sweet. We have one of those night lights in here. Move this over. Well, you might have seen that in another video. See, it's in the daytime, and then watch it. It gets dark, and the light gets brighter and brighter, and you have an automatic night light there. That's pretty cool. All right, transitioning into the formal dining room, I guess you'd call it. Just the flooring here is the main attraction that we did. All new sockets. There's a hidden socket back here. This might be the only room that I don't have a USB in because it's the dining room. Right, I don't have a USB in here. Really nice stair-nose transition. This was a Pergo piece to match this piece. And we used a quarter round under it to seal that little gap between the carpet, which they put up the wall, which is killer, and the wood. So it's a perfectly round piece and a slight angle from flat to kind of give you that feel of moving into the lower. Now, that wasn't intentional, but I think it's kind of cool. It's just how it ended up. Dual zone AC, I might have mentioned that one day. You have upstairs controller too, so you never have the problem with the upstairs or downstairs not being the same that you set it for, because you can customize each one. All new plugs in here. We'll keep the mirror, I guess. Hey. Plugs back there, plugs. New carpet, of course. Here's the USB for this room. Little USB action. This is the one area that I haven't, that I really need to clean. My tool central right here. Let me just show you the porch light before we go to other things. It was an old rusty one, and now we have just a nice modern one. Every bulb in the house has been replaced with the GE daytime light LEDs. Most of them are 60s. And before we go upstairs, I got to show you a couple more things. So the downstairs bathroom. This is the first place that I ever got automatically closing lid. This is the first room that I got completely done. I took off the mirror to paint this in all cases, in all rooms. I pulled off the mirrors too to paint behind them, get nice coverage, install that cheap light up there. New sockets, new covers, yada, yada, yada. I took this off, which was chrome, painted it the perfect white, three coats, put it back up. Really cherried out the look with the whole white and gray look is the theme for this. Of course, this isn't the perfect match. And just this week, I put in the new floor in the cabinet, silicone seal down the middle because you can't get the whole piece in at once. So pretty nice little bathroom. I like the size. I like the width of this sink. It isn't like a little tiny sink too. I do like that. All right, so the secret little, this is just a hall closet. And your secret storage, which I probably want to adjust those clips. It's not supposed to open by itself. Now this was covered in dirt and spider webs and everything. I spent an hour in here last night and just cleaned everything, vacuumed up all the spider webs and dirt everywhere. And this is a nice little storage area. And some of the house supplies, some roof tiles, carpets, pergos, blinds, different things back there, my WRX wheel, stuff I don't need that often, and storage. This is a pretty nice little bonus storage area, pretty big, but it's kind of hard to get into that dwarf door. Let me see, how does that work? I'll have to figure that clip out later and see how it's supposed to work. Oh well. Like a glove! That's stupid. Alright, let's take you guys upstairs. New carpet, of course. I pulled out about 1,000 staples off this house when all the floors were all plywood when I was doing the renovation mostly. Let's save the master for last. First, we'll head straight into the office, which might be the biggest room in the entire upstairs. Big office. Computer's gonna be in here. A view of the lake across the street. I don't know if you can see it, probably not. There's a lake right there. And you can see the lake behind all these houses. And you can swim in the lake and stuff like that if you want. In here, painted everything, of course. New blinds, not a new holder, that's fine. Just got all new blinds to hang there. Nice, white, fresh sockets. Did I forget a USB in the office? Serious? Maybe I did forget a USB in the office. I might have to get one. Huh. Well, I mean, you don't really need it in the office. Maybe you do. And also I painted every closet same color and replaced every wood dowel with brushed nickel closet rods, custom cut and everything. I think I showed a video of that sometime. I can't remember. Then we'll go to his room. We just got a little, like, whatever, bathroom closet. Nothing done at all in here. The upstairs bathroom, I haven't even touched it, haven't even looked at it. So this is one of the future projects, to clean this up a little bit, make it a little nicer. It's not that nice a room. And into his room, again, no light, but at least there's a little bit of light here. Dumping boxes, because we're short on boxes, so we just dump the box out and go bring it back. A couple nice shelves. I think I got him that when he was 2 years old. At the zoo, by the way. I don't know if it was Virginia Zoo or San Francisco Zoo. I can't even remember. Must have been, yeah, it was in California. Some troll action, whatever. His teepee. His books. Dresser might go in here because it's a small-ish room. He does have his USB and he has his nightlight on the plugs in there. Closets painted, nickel rods, usual stuff. Head over to her room. We're almost done here, guys. Her room, about the same. Some troll action, some princess action, princess castles, rosy violet blinds, which she probably likes. Did you notice on his room? No closet doors on the two kids' rooms. We're going to do a custom accent curtain so they can pick their favorite color for a custom accent curtains here. And then, of course, we got the one-piece carpet, no cuts, and they were able to put it all in without a transition, which was really what I wanted, because there used to be closet doors here that I took off, pain in the butt on all that. Painted closets, brushed nickel bars. The only closet shelf I replaced is this one. You can see, I don't remember, it might be pine or whatever. It can be kind of cheap since it's indoors. And of course, nailed down with the Ryobi. I think I had a video on that. Big 18-inch shelf, really, really big. You could fit a lot of stuff in there. And let's go, almost out of the breath. See, I never stop. Here's the upstairs AC controller. There's the old lady chandelier. Master bedroom / bathroom. Not the biggest, I mean, the GoPro might make it look bigger than it is. Not the biggest master, but plenty, actually. You know what, as I say that, it looks pretty big to me now. I mean, I don't know. I did buy that bronze curtain rod to match this whole theme in this master area. We're doing a bronze industrial kind of look. It had blinds, curtains, whatever, so I got a big old bronze thick rod. That's what she said. Balcony out there, sawdust from all the work we did, cutting all the wood. Painted everything. There's our his and hers USB sockets. We're gonna be beside the beds, charge our phones. Replaced all of those vents except the laundry one I showed you with the brand new ones and everything, just get it all fresh. Then the master bath is probably like one of the nicest places. I'm replacing this like today. Don't worry about all the screw holes. I was trying a few things. It doesn't want to stick good. I got new stuff right there. I'll be messing with that. 1/4 round molding there going in front of this closet. It'll clean it right up, look good. Our favorite thing probably is the 9 bronze lights across the top. On the dimmer, of course. Really cool, really cool. Keep that low, I'll make it bright for the video. On here, even painted all the side cabinets, including the borders, and then we realized we can't really open them. And then we double realize that we don't really care because we don't use them much. Just put stuff you hardly ever use in there. There you go. And just like downstairs, replaced the wood flooring on both of these sink underneaths. Put in pipe insulation under that and then a white cap to clean it up a bit, even though the holes are a little big. Again, white silicone, seal the edges, custom cuts and everything. Really sweet, really sweet. And the very, very last, three gigantic closets. Her closet. These closet doors are sketchy though, man. We need to do something about that. This is like a 12 or 14 foot closet. You can hardly see the end back there. Really, really huge closet for a girl, you know, bags, sweaters, shoes, all kinds of stuff. So the closet door barely moves. It's all grindy, like sandpaper. All right, my closet, starting to get that ready. Just haven't moved in yet. Still a nice sized closet. This ain't small either. Then we got a third closet, which will be the storage. So we got three closets in this room, in this master bath. It's my favorite part. And of course, Gerald again did this floor. Beautiful, beautiful job. I did the moldings. That's why they're not as good and they're kind of crappy. A little bit of gaps and stuff like that. But I had to cut both the height and the 45s. This one's terrible. Even with the nails, I just couldn't get it to come together very good. But when I stand back, I think it ain't terrible. It is all flush against the paint and everything, you know. It's just not perfect. You know how I am. Real nice there. A little gap there. Whatever, whatever. Pretty dang good. Pretty close. So, that's it. Don't want to drag this on. I think we're done. Nothing special in the bathroom. The toilet doesn't work. It doesn't flush or anything, so that's a project later. This thing is kind of cool. It's a built-in vent and heater at the same time. So like one side sucks and the other side blows heat for like winter. You can choose what you want to turn on. That's pretty cool. I forgot to do this register also now that I think about it. All right, there's another one to do. But overall, we haven't touched this bathroom either. We're leaving a few things, you know, for later. A few things for later. All right, guys, that's the tour of Last Human's new house. Moving in this week. Then I'll start thinking about some car videos again. Start getting this channel up and running again. This is like a dream come true. A miracle on 34th Street. Really psyched. And I'll see you guys again. If you sat through this whole thing, well, then I'm impressed.